Quick disclaimer before the video starts. I'm in no shape or form a movement guard, and I'm not trying to be one. I just know how to utilize some movement techs in fights, so I wanted to share. Enjoy the video. Hi guys, Nix here. If you don't know me, my name is Nix. I go by Nix Ames on most social media platforms. I stream almost daily on Twitch TV. And I'm here today to show you guys how I personally try and utilize movement mechanics in my gameplay. Alright, to start the whole thing off, I'm gonna talk to you about super jumps, I think people call them. But basically, zip jumps where you utilize scroll jump to get a boost in height. So basically, if you press right on a zip line, there's a small window where if you jump, you get a boost in speed and height. So you can use it to outplay your opponents. Like so. Like if I wanna cross somewhere, I go like this. Suddenly I've gained some height. It can also be used to climb stories in buildings faster, and it's pretty simple. I have my my jump bound to scroll down, as you can see on the mouse cam right now. So whenever I grab it, I just jump. No other inputs, it's as simple as that. Alright, second thing we're gonna look at is wall bounces. Wall bounces are good, nothing major and not something you'll really be utilizing too much in game, but they're really cool and they're fun to move around with. So basically what you do to do a wall bounce is you run up towards a wall at an angle, right? If you run straight with it, you gotta strafe into it. But to start off, to make it easy at you, you run at it at an angle. When you get close to the wall, you slide, then jump and let go of all inputs. And then your character will do like a climb animation where you then just jump off the wall, if that makes sense. Okay. So here, slide towards the wall bounce. Showing it again, boom, like so. Right, so what you'll probably notice is if you try and wall bounce something like this, it's gonna do like that, like a weird mount animation. The way to overcome that is to hold an input in. So if I'm going this way and I'm gonna be moving out left, I'm gonna hold an A when I get to the wall bounce part. That way it doesn't grab on, but I can use my wall bounce. Same thing goes if you're trying to do it out that way. I don't know if I can do it right here, let's see. Yeah, I could. I hold in D, and that way I keep my momentum and I keep my speed while bouncing out. All right, now I'm gonna show you the most beneficial movement technique in the game. And if you don't already know about it, get on it. It's called tap strafing. So basically what it is when you do a turn like this, you can tell I kind of move like this, right? I move at a slight angle, but with tap strafes, you can do like angle switches, and you can basically do 180s if you're really good at them, right? Without losing any speed. So if I'm going around this one, I slide out, tap strafe around the corner, and then I've lost my opponent, right? Just like that. And the way you do tap strafes are in your keybinds, you bound, move forward to scroll one. So you see I've jump bound to scroll down and forward to scroll up. So whenever I scroll, as you can see on the mouse cam, I move slightly forward, right? So basically, you just run and then you scroll forward whenever you want to turn around. Then you hold in the input of which direction you want to go. You need to let go of Thobby or else it won't register that second input. But if I slide here and I want to go to the left, I simply slide, jump and scroll up while turning to the left. So you can see my pointer finger starts up by here by the scroll wheel. Look at the mouse cam again. Then I end up all the way over there. Some things you can do with tap strafes are really cool, and one of the most beneficial things, especially in the current meta of the game with Octane being really strong, is you can tap strafe on the jumps on a jump pad. So let's say I come here and slide, I can press tap strafe right now, and suddenly I've done a 180. Alright? So you can see, that's really beneficial. And it's again the same technique where you simply just do scroll up while you move, turn your mouse around. But one thing that's kind of important is whenever you do tap strafes is you can't swing them around, then you lose your momentum, like you saw there, right? If you do it smooth and clean, then you'll be able to do some really nice tap strafes. Then it's all about practice. Everybody can tap strafe. And it's very easy, and you got that easy. I know you guys do. Alright, while we're on the topic of jump pads, I'm quickly gonna show another trick that people don't really know about. If you crouch in front of a jump pad and punch, or generally, actually, if you just stand in front of a jump pad and punch, you get a complete vertical jump on a jump pad that you can basically infinitely stay on until you either die or the jump pads get destroyed. But if you crouch by a jump pad, then punch at the jump pad, like if you just punch in like this general direction, right? And then give it an input afterwards, you'll get a boost. So I'm gonna right now do a punch and put in S, which is backwards. That way I fly backwards. And then if I implement a tap strafe into that, right, you can see there's some crazy stuff that can really be done. So again, I'm gonna put in an A input now, right? I fly out to the left, and I tap strafe back. It's very, very, very situational, but like maybe sometime, one way it can be used is, let's say you're fighting, you got a guy weak there, he's gone behind the heady over there, run up to your jump pad, crouch in front of it, give it the S input, and suddenly you're flying at him without having to do any like crazy movement tech other than just basically getting up to it. And yeah, all right. The last movement tech I'm going to talk about in this video is super glides. And if you know, super glides are really, really, really hard to consistently do. And not many people have even like remotely gotten it down to perfection. I would say that the BTY rec kit is probably the closest we have right now to a player actually like knowing how to super glide every single time, right? So if you don't know how to super glide, I don't really want to go over it in this video. There's other videos talking about that. But what I want to say is, if you get it down, it's a cool movement tech that can make for some cool clips. But I don't think it's something you should be doing if you're playing high level ranked, because if you fuck it up, then you're just standing here like this and you're like, oh fuck, and you're just dead, right? So unless you're really, really consistent, I would keep this to like a pop meta. But what I want to show you with super glides is I like to do this, right? I like to run up here, and then on this wall I try and super glide, and then I do this wall super glide, and then I do this climb here super glide, right? That way, and I go backwards in the same kind of pattern, right? And then I just do these kind of patterns here where there's all these different heights of climbing. Because one thing is learning the super glide on like the walls down underneath, but actually learning on this wall, right, there's not really any wall here that's the same height. So learning to do a super glide on this one like that, then going over here, this is a new height. Learning to do it on this height is then going to be beneficial as well, because every time you kind of get used to a height, you're going to be able to possibly utilize that in game. Again, this is another height. Boom. Right? That was not really a good one. That was a good one, right? So you like going up here and just playing around, doing it on that wall, maybe going up here, and like if you're even wanting, just try and do like a little super glide like that, you know? Stuff like that is gonna give you more experience, and then you can take that with you in game. What I wanna say is I stream almost daily on my Twitch channel. So if you guys have any questions regarding these movement techs that I try and tell you guys to utilize, and if you want to see me try and utilize them in game, you can catch me there. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I really hope to see some movement warlords out there. Again, I'm not a movement warlord, but I feel like I have a little bit to give, alright? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.